our ocean faces unprecedented threats from pollution, overfishing, habitat loss, and climate change. Progress on the ocean SDG, life below water, is not on track to achieve its ambitious targets. In response, in 2020, UNDP, with support from Sweden and Norway, launched the Ocean Innovation Challenge aimed at accelerating progress on SDG 14. The first of several planned challenges, launched in January 2020, focused on SDG 14.1, marine pollution. UNDP received over 600 concept proposals, a testament to the tremendous global interest in addressing this issue. Following a rigorous and demanding process of internal and external review and assessment, UNDP has selected its first cohort of 9 ocean innovators. These innovations cut across a wide range of technological, policy, regulatory, and other approaches to reducing marine pollution. Today, I'm very pleased to announce UNDP's 2020 Ocean Innovators.
Every year, the Maldives generate about 25,000 tons of plastic waste, and due to poor waste management practices, as much as a third of it ends up in the oceans. With support from the Ocean Innovation Challenge, we'll be helping the Maldives to put in place an extended producer responsibility framework that will close the loop on ocean plastic pollution.
Here in the Comoros, in the heart of the Indian Ocean, UNDP is working with government to address the challenge of ocean plastic pollution through the promotion of innovative financing mechanisms for the collection, reuse, and recycling of waste. That addresses both pollution, but it helps to promote economic opportunities for local communities and the private sector.
The Philippines, province of Palawan, faces serious challenges with solid waste management and ocean plastic pollution. With support from Ocean Innovation Challenge, EPKI will help to shape local regulations on single-use plastic and introduce extended producers' responsibility laws. We will create new income opportunities for indigenous people to manufacture low-cost, environmentally benign alternatives to plastic packaging.
Costa Rica discards 550 tons of plastic daily, and 80% of it goes to the ocean.
Impacting ecosystems and communities.
Expanding existing laws, this project will create policies to address these problems.
By establishing the recycling deposit refund system.
Incentivize reduction in fishing net pollution.
Strengthen regulations on cigarette disposal.
Some 5 to 12 million metric tons of plastic waste now enters our ocean every year. A wide range of policy responses have been applied by different countries as they try to address plastic pollution. This innovation will create the world's first global plastics policy tracking tool, which will help stakeholders at all levels to identify and replicate best practice in plastics policy development and implementation. The project will also identify trends in plastic policy tools as a means to predict plastics material flows.
Microfibers released from textiles is a major source of microplastics pollution in the oceans. Our OIC project works with textile manufacturing in Asia and cutting-edge research that improves industry understanding of microfiber release from textile manufacturing. We aim to inspire innovation to reduce microfiber release from the production stage and see industry-wide change to tackle this urgent problem in a socially just and economical way.
Like many small island developing states, Cape Verde faces problems with coastal eutrophication.
Our project will use digital technologies to help Cape Verde wastewater sector optimize biological removal and recovery of nutrients as well as fertilizers, promote the safe use of drinking water, and reduce operating treatment costs.
The widespread of industrial fertilizers have created a major challenge in the ocean due to the runoff of phosphorus and nitrogen contaminants. These create dead zones at the sea ecosystem, which are a major cause of concern.
With support from the OIC, Pico's Terra sustainably harvests seaweed from the ocean that can be used to help farmers save money, increase their crop yield, and be more sustainable and non-polluting.
Styrofoam and polystyrofoam are the most common insulation in perishable food transport. Millions of styrofoam boxes are produced, sold, and discarded every year. In the Philippines, studies show that up to 20% of this plastic waste ends up in our oceans. Fortuna's coconut coolers are the first cold storage container insulated with discarded coconut husks, and it competes with polystyrene on price and performance. Seafood and produce traders save money by switching to our long-lasting coconut coolers. In fact, they helped us design it. This project will also support new green jobs and reduce CO2 emissions from upcycling millions of coconut husks instead of burning them as waste.
Congratulations and good luck to UNDP's 2020 Ocean Innovators. You can follow the progress of our innovators on our webpage and our social media accounts. Be sure to check the OIC website for information on our upcoming second call for proposals on ocean innovations for sustainable fisheries and aquaculture. Does your organization have a good idea? You too could become a UNDP Ocean Innovator.